In the early 1900s, down Lawrence County way, working in the quarries was how you earned your pay. Louis Baker was a carver, and a good one, so it's told. The stress of carving took him when he was 21 years old. Bedford, Indiana was the place that he called home, and Louis earned his living making carvings out of stone. It was limestone work that killed him, and limestone gave him fame, for the monument in Bedford that bears young Baker's name. The other carvers liked him and mourned that he was gone. They took the block of limestone that he'd been working on. They carved a fitting tribute so we'd remember him, a copy of his workbench just the way that it had been. His blueprints and carving tools, the way he left them there, even little mounds of dust reproduced with love and care. From far and wide people come to see this work of art and remember Louis Baker, a man of noble heart. Bedford, Indiana was the place that he called home, and Louis earned his living making carvings out of stone. It was limestone work that killed him, and limestone gave him fame, for the monumental tombstone that bears young Baker's name. At night in Green Hill Cemetery, when a chill is in the air, you might see a ghostly figure standing near his workbench there. Louis Baker was a carver, and a good one, so it's told. The stress of carving took him when he was 21 years old. Bedford, Indiana was the place that he called home, and Louis earned his living making carvings out of stone. It was limestone work that killed him, and limestone gave him fame, for the monumental tombstone that bears young Baker's name. For the monument in Bedford that bears young Baker's name.